today we're working with members of the Marine Corps and Forces Recon. We're going through weapons awareness and some of the military practices, room clearances, multiple opponent situations, changing weapons, familiarity with placement and movement through a space with a defined objective.
It'll be here, your weapon's down. When you make a decision, get it up. It's all one armed, right. Elbows in, and then push, bang. And as you make entry in, you'll take a look, you see what it is, you make a decision whether you want to engage the targets that are in there or whether you want to come back and get behind that wall and think about it.
Remember, the friendly has a white mask on. Let's
make this. The friendly has a white mask on. I say that so he doesn't shoot me.
Make a transition. Nice and smooth. No race. Shoulder it. Get it all the way up. Drop that left hand when you're ready. Keep moving through.
This thing jams.
I know, I saw that.
Yeah. Did it? Throw it. If these things jam, roll them on the ground and get rid of them.
You guys set something else up.
I got another plan. Hey, let's get him loaded up and ready to play.
Let's put somebody right next to the door, either on top of that thing right here or right next to the door. I've come from the stunt world. That helps me to keep this real. I like that entire military and stunt attitude. These guys are just up for anything.
Michael, can you come behind the desk?
When he comes through, I want to make all his action come to you, which is going to take away from your guy up there. I want to try
like
to trigger
that.
Just to see whether he actually can pick up on him. Very nice.
Exactly.
That was very frank-esque.
Ray, don't you take body shots? What? I think you hit me in the head like 30 times.
Right when after he killed him, he saw me, it was like three right to the head, like straight on. Perfect. Okay. There's just one thing that when he came in. Yeah. I know this is in the way. You see him, boom, you take out this target, you see him, you're still moving away from cover. Boom, you see this guy right here?
Yes. I'm moving.
Even if you move away from somewhere, you can always move back to it if that's where you want to be.
In one process, you're thinking about it all the time. You're just thinking. And eventually, it's to get that thinking out of the way.
Right, and just do it.
So it's just that, it's like when you learn to drive a car.
Right,
you
know, exactly.
Once you pass your test, that's when you learn how to drive.
Right.
So you're doing everything up to proficiency, but then you learn. This is probably the most rigorous training that I've ever been involved with. Basically, we start crack of dawn, sort of 5:45. We're up. We do our military and weapons training, and then we do our mixed martial arts training.
After we finished our stretching, hike, and our grab bar, which is a bunch of calisthenic exercises, we would then do fight training. One of the things that you must realize is that an actor who does an action film has to be in better condition than a fighter, for example, a world championship boxer. A world championship boxer prepares for a championship match, which is going to last 15 rounds. And yet, an actor might have to fight 5 days a week, 12 hours per day. So the actor who's going to do action films has to be in better condition. Okay, the next thing we're going to go through is some defense. What we're going to do is we're going to do a couple of multiple attacks where there's more than one attacker. What we're going to do now is we're going to do some fighting against weapons.
Come on now.
Good job. And we wrecked the set as well.
My weekend starts when this ends, and I get my Sunday to lie in a puddle and get ready for Monday.